Hello beloved, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your sister Eliso Owoye. Thank you so much for always turning around. May God Almighty bless you for your labor of love in Jesus' name. If today is your first time of coming, you are highly welcome. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Turn on the notification button whenever I upload any video, you will be notified. Thank you so much. Stay in as we go into today's topic. Very short, and I believe it minister something great into your life. As a mother, as a future mother or father or future father, stay with me. Hello, you are welcome back. In today's topic, I really want to discuss with us. Because there's a Bible verse I've come across and it has been eating my heart. And I really want people to know this out there. This story in the book of 1 Kings. Yes, the book of 1 Kings chapter 21. If you read it from 1 to down, please take your time and read it. I just want to, because of my time, I really don't want to spend more time. Because a lot of people don't have time to be listening to people. Please take your time on your own and read this Bible verse. Since I've come across this Bible verse, it hits my spirit, man. So I'm careful of what we are doing as a parent, as a father, mother, even future parents to be, or whatever, you haven't have children yet, because the Bible says whatsoever a man do, you will definitely reap. They say, wait, that seems right unto a man, I'm enjoying them, but the end thereof is destruction. Whatever you are doing and you are enjoying it, definitely anything that is so sweet, it has bitterness, it has its own way. That be bitterness to us. I pray that will not be our portion. That's why in this world we need to be very, very careful. Very, very careful. I'm going to rush this message. I will not take much time. Because this is a topic that I really need to take a lot of time. But I want you to go and study this Bible verse. 1 Kings chapter 21 from 1 to the end. Take your time and read it. And this is a story of this man, this king. How? This king, he has everything as a king, but he was envious of a little thing that a poor man, the garden that the little man is taking care of. It was heavy. The same in this world today. People will have everything. Your heart will also be longing on how to take other people on to yourself. And you have it all. In this life, nobody's comfortable, or nobody's satisfied or content in what they have. We always want to have more and more and more. There is nothing that we bring to this world, and definitely there's nothing we are taking back. Where I am going is this. We just have to be careful of whatever we are doing, because there are a lot of people, because of self-centered, my heart desire, I want to have this, I want to have that. We do everything to have what we want. Some people kill, some people lie against people, some people cheat, some people do different kind of evil just to have what they want. Trust me that what all those things that you are doing today, you will definitely reap it tomorrow, because you are planting seed. It will come back to you tomorrow. If it didn't come to you, it will come to your children. That's why you have to be very careful in this Bible passage. This king, after everything that he done to this poor man, Naboth, after all, he killed the man because he wanted to have his position. Then the sin come against him. He repents. The place that shocked me there, in that Bible verse, spend time and read it. There are a lot to learn in that place. But at this particular place, I really want to figure out. You understand? After all, he repents. They go say that because he has repented, I will forgive him. I will no longer bring the punishment upon him, but I will take it to his sons. You see, a lot of us are suffering today for what we don't know anything about. What our ancestors have done. We are suffering for it today without we knowing it. You that are still fresh as a parent now, please stop planting evil in the future of your children by trying to cheat people now. I want you to know, in everything that any man does, God will definitely forgive us. You will definitely suffer for it. You will definitely suffer for it. In the life of Apostle Paul,
Apostle Paul was a man that was fighting against the children of God, stopping them from preaching the gospel. But later, when God invited him and God arrested him to himself, he suffered for kingdom's sake. He suffered. Did you get that? He suffered. Even the life of David, every sin that David committed, God forgive him. He still suffered for all. I want you to know, in every act, in every evil deed that any man is doing, there is always payback. He definitely come back to you. If he didn't come to you, please think about those children. Don't go and put your children in stress tomorrow, suffering tomorrow. Innocent children that are just coming up. A lot of people, you have children, you are still doing many evil, drugs, doing different kinds that will lead you to a prison. After that, you put your children or your wife or your husband, you put them in suffering when you are in there. Please think about your children before doing anything. Above all, let's think about our soul, because you don't know when death is coming. If you die in that particular thing that you are doing, where will you end your soul? Where will you end? Please think about your children. I'm just rushing this because I don't want to take your time. I pray that the Holy Spirit minister more into your hearts. Please stop planting evil in the future of your children. If you don't have anything yet, endure. Pray to God. The problem that a lot of us are having is social media. You see some people post picture, you don't know how they get it. You just want to do everything to also have. You don't know if that person has even eaten for 2 days because he wear clothes. You don't even know how the clothes come. You want to go and do anything by thing to be there. Bini say is yegbe or sensible. Patience and endurance is what we need to go. Please turn away from every evil that you are doing, because as you are planting into your life, paravation, you repent. What about your children? Our parents always say that to people then, that if your head is strong, your children's head are not strong. You understand? Please stop doing evil. The world we are is glorious, it's wonderful, and it's mystery. It's mystery. Let us come back home and continue to think the way God expects us to. Reason, because what are we fighting for? What are we running for? Or to kill each other? Or to cheat anyone for? All those things we are running after, one day, we'll naked. One day, we'll naked and face our Creator. It's only this bread that we have that makes us a living being that people celebrate you. When this hair is gone, we become scary thing that people turn away from us. It now remains you and your Creator. Please, let us be careful of what we are doing because of our children, because of our future, because of our soul above all. Our soul. There is nothing in this world, but there is glory in this world with Jesus. Give your life to Him and continue to follow the step of Jesus. I pray that God minister this word. I just rush it. It's a topic I really supposed to settle down to teach on. I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. God bless you. Please like, comment if you have the time, and share. Let it reach a lot of people. Let this message go viral by the help of the Holy Spirit. That, you know, if death didn't happen to anybody, we don't remember that death exists though. Until it happens, say, this thing exists. I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for now. Stay blessed.